I'll let him. I don't. Is my Jay back in here or not? Hey, Mike Cockapoo. Do you want to come up? Or Jay, or both of yous, and then yous can let people in and. Hey,
how are you holding up?
Listen, I have to sit here and be a woman, put my big ass knickers on, and just do what I'm doing.
Yeah, I really want that guy back in that.
I'm saying share it because I want him back in. Because listen, I was interested there. I was listening to what I don't know what happened there. It just went down, so I'm obviously getting reported.
Yeah.
Nobody was saying anything wrong. There was no screaming, no shouting. Everybody was just listening and being educated. I should have put something like that on the live for.
I think you know it's probably the bots. There's probably certain words that are on their list, and
somebody want to go and tell.
I can't even remember his username.
Sorry, everybody, it was a phone call. Can you hear me?
Yeah, they're going to try and find out. So look, Pella, obviously I've been listening in, and I just want to let people, you know, there's not a lot of people in here compared to, I just want to let people know that, you know, last night when I came in and said what I said, I didn't have the context of the word that Pearl uses. I hadn't personally recalled hearing it, but when I spoke to somebody else, they said, you remember, you were in the live on this day, not the one that Pearl shared. It's difficult to get the recording because it was too long ago. Once I understood that, I had a lot more understanding of how it had just been used in the wrong way, in the wrong context. You know, and I just want to say that so that people understand where my head's at, because Pearl and I have spoken this morning, but we haven't really spoken about that. So I wanted to share that with you so people understand.
So I'll leave it up to you just to get people back in the boxes. But I would like that young man in. I forgot his name again. Sorry.
Emperor. Does anyone know Emperor?
Somebody said.
Can you share it to him and get him back in, bless him, because he got flipping cut off.
Yeah, he did. I think there was a word which it was the knight supremacy word that potentially triggered the bots and took the live down.
Okay, there was a lady actually.
Listen, I'm not playing dumb. I don't even know what that means.
It means nothing.
Sorry guys. He's in Angie's live at the moment.
Oh, okay.
Thank you. If somebody can go and tell him that I did have a 10-minute banana, but I would like to come back and for him to come back if he wants to and explain and like tell me what he was like on telling us, because I would love for him to finish what he was saying.
Yeah. Just so you know, in this live, I don't have box control from here, so that's
it's
a bit.
All right, I've got it. I'm cool. Just trying to.
Okay.
But Pearl has specifically asked for people not to come in and blow smoke up her ass. I'm just saying.
Definitely not. Well, I don't want people who watches me all the time, who knows what I'm about. Thank you, Miss Red. I don't want people to come in here and blow and make it all nicey. I want people who doesn't know what I'm about, who doesn't know, who doesn't watch me lives, who doesn't understand where I come from. I want them people to come in the box and to explain about what's going on, like what I've said and how I have actually made people feel. That's because I need to know when I'm doing wrong. I need to be called out on it. And if I'm not made aware, now I understand. I understood last night after when I was in the comments. And listening after, to it,
when I was in the comments and listening to it,
reading the comments, that That's when I understood, oh my God, everybody's like, I've got everybody up in arms. What is so bad? Because I've never ever been around anybody but gypsies and travellers, and later in my later life, I've start mixing with non-gypsies and non-travellers. There's still, I'm still in my circle of friends, and I don't know why, because it's not a thing where I would never go there, because lots of me friends, the same as Tori and the same as Pagey Baby, a lot of black, is that the wrong word again? A lot of people on here, I am friends with, not off the app, but we go in each other's boxes, we speak. I'm not digging at all. I'm not digging a hole. I'm trying to explain where I'm coming from.
Just ignore that, so them sort of comments. You do what you need to do.
Black people or people of colour, I've never been around them. I don't know what is offensive. Like, if people hasn't been around gypsies or travellers, they don't know what's offensive to us. And when people come in and say something, no, do you know most hated? I'm sorry, you're the only one I'm refusing. And you know for why? Me and you were on a live the other day, and what did you do to me on that live? You spit at your screen.
Yeah, he's horrible, pal. Yeah. Just leave him.
Can I just explain as well why that happened? Because he was saying he had his baby mam, as he calls her, beside him, and he was going on, he wants all the single ladies. So I called him out, and then I said, you're a narcissist, and he spit at the camera, so that was spitting in my face. So definitely not. Get him out my live, mods, block him, and you're not welcome in here, most hated. So very sorry, and I really mean it, go away, you are not welcome in.
He's gone.
So sorry, everybody. Anybody else can get in. Definitely not him. He's gone.
Excuse me, Pearl. Can I just say, like, you know, you say about, like, this coloured people. Like, see, things like that. Like, Paige, you can, like, back me up here, because, honestly, I'm not quite sure about it. Like, you know when people's, like, coloured people or black people, see, with things like that, I get scared because I'm, like, I don't know what to call them, because, obviously, me, well, I'm white. I can admit that, and, well, obviously, Pearl, you're no gypsy community. We can get away with darker colour because, well, our blood, when the sun's out, we go darker, don't we? Like, my granddad's white, but he is really, really dark. But can someone just, like, explain to me what do we...
Europe, that's where we originate from. So that's in our blood too. Yes. See, there you go. Somebody's just said it's black, not coloured. Sorry, honestly, and this is a learning curve for us. We are truly sorry. We are not meaning to offend anybody. By...
Do you see why now, then? You know when people keep saying black people are aggressive and black women are aggressive? Do you get kind of why we're fed up now? Because, I'm not lucky. That was really angry.
Sorry to butt in, but black people are the most loveliest and nicest people I've met. I'm like, every time I'm around them, like, I've been around so many, and I'm not going to sit here and lie and pretend that this and that. I have got black cousins, and some people are going to think, oh my God, Gorgie. But no, I have got black cousins that are what are gypsies, you know, as well. People, and they're the most loving people I've ever met in my entire life.
You know, there's people that have black cousins, they even have black children, but they can still be racist. So you see when people say, oh, I've got black cousins, like, that really irritates me, because listen, there's people that have black children that have mixed race children that are racist. Do you get what I mean? So
yeah, anyone can be racist, and I don't agree with it, because some people slip up and say wrong things. I've said it a lot of times.
When we say what racist is or racism, it's a very, like, it's a term with a lot of layers to it. Like I said,
like, I know exactly.
People need to stop thinking, unknown lover, that racism is just. Okay, so you're worried about saying certain words. If you say the wrong thing, it makes you racist. That's not what it is at all.
That's why, like,
it's never that. And it's not the old school terminology of okay.
Misfits.
It's like, you know, the NF, and it's like Tommy Robinson, all these people that are very clearly racist. That's not just what racism is, though.
That's what I mean. That's the thing.
That's the, like, it's not.
like, some people, listen, some people can slip up and say the wrong words, and, like, I'm not here to stick up for nobody. I'm just saying what I think on it. Like, Pearl, listen, what you did was wrong. You apologise. You're a good woman for that. You've always been a good woman. I've always come across your lives. I thought, you know what? I love this woman. She's lovely. But some people do slip up and make mistakes. Listen, I've had a few errors in my time. I'm bipolar. I've said horrible things to someone. And listen, sometimes it slips up. And like, pal, you know what it's like. You're a gypsy. You wouldn't like it if someone said, you know, to you. Yeah, and that's exactly why.
And this is what I'm saying. But can I just say to you, you're saying I've slipped up. I said the word because I did not know the meaning behind it. It's something I've said all my life. Now I do. Yeah. There'll be no more. How you've just said, I'm slipping up. I've never slipped up. It's so, a word.
Is it right if Misfits has a chat?
Hi, Pearl. How are you going? How are you holding up?
It's not Emma. You're right. Sorry.
How are you holding up? You all right?
Yeah, I'm good. Thank you.
All right. I'm from Australia and I'm an Aboriginal. I have just come in here just to let you know that. Even though you said it to a black person, since the dawn of time, we've been called monkeys, put in chains, all the rest of it, made slaves. You know, that's the heritage of our mob, you know. So, sorry, I'm a bit nervous to speak. I haven't, you know, I don't really like speaking in boxes. But I just wanted to educate you on... You can't really tell by the colour of the skin from some Aboriginals in Australia. So it's a bit offensive. You might get caught out, like, trying to say it to a white person. Do you know what I mean? If you say it to an Aboriginal that's white from Australia. Mm-hmm. That's all I wanted to come and say. Like, people were saying, like, how you were saying that maybe you won't say it to a black person. We still find it offensive being Aboriginal.
All together.
I'm just trying to tell you, darling, I know you're not racist. I understand. And I understand that you're very sorry and I can see it. I'm just trying to tell you that maybe you won't be able to see by the colour of their skin of the mob that they come from Australia. Just be careful.
Thank you.
That's all I wanted to say. I hope you get through this okay. And I know it's a bit shaky, and I'm with you, darling.
Thank you for that.
All right, I'll drop out now. Thanks, Jay.
All right, Miss Vince.
It's not letting me go.
I don't know where Emperor is. I have looked for him.
He's in Andy's lab. I went to him and I told him to drop because... Sorry, Angie is not a platform that you go and talk about race. Angie is a clout chaser, a racist, and just, yeah, but I'm not even going to make it about that woman. Just feel like if you are trying to get educated or do you want something, Angie's not the live to do it, mate.
I was going to say, I just want for people to know, on here, listen, I'm not racist, never have been and never will be, right? No, I've got, there's no tears coming, definitely no tears coming. I cried all my tears last night. So I'm not coming on here to sit and cry any tears, but I'm coming on here to tell people I am truly, truly sorry. I apologise. And now I know that that is an offensive word. This is what I'm trying to do. Sorry, Tori, and I obeyed you, baby.
Oh, Paige is gone.
Hello, Jay. Hello, pal. Hello, Torian.
Hi, Bart.
Hi, Bart. You all right?
How are you guys?
Good, thank you.
I'm good. And... this is who I was with the agency, everybody. But this is now who I'm not with the agency. So while she's on here, I'm just going to tell everybody that I'm not in the agency because they can't be seen to, I don't know, explain it, please, Bert.
So basically, I completely disagree with Pearl's actions as a human being, personally, and I don't think what she did was right. I don't agree with a lot of what my creators do, if I'm completely honest with you, but I don't have any control over it, unfortunately. And yeah, it's more about what's a joke? Sorry, I don't know what's a joke. I don't agree with what she did, but she, I don't think she meant it in the way that it's coming across that she meant it. No. Because she obviously didn't mean it to be racist or whatever else. I literally just solely came into this box to say that Pearl is no longer part of my agency. So and that's the end of that. You know, it is what it is. But I will always have Pearl's back. She's one of my very dear friends in real life, and I absolutely adore her.
It's fair enough. But...
see you soon, guys.
Bye, babe. Thank you. Bye. For that.
Bye. Bye, love.
Someone in the comments has asked, Pearl, what was your actual true intention of saying that?
Sorry, what was what?
Someone in the comments has asked, what was your actual true intention? Or what
no
did
intention you, at all.
On that, sorry, not intention. What did you actually mean behind it when you said like, that to Laura?
I say that is me because I say it to my family. Like I've said, it's a word I use every day that come across me when I say, hey, you fucking cheeky Kents. That's what that intention was. And why I reference one of my grandchildren is because of the word that I used, they are ginger, and I've got one ginger grandchild who was the cheekiest out of everybody, and that's why I always say, and this is me cheekiest, the word I used. That's why. And there's videos out there that has been shown that I really do genuinely use that word every day, and I genuinely have said it on the videos that were showed to, no, it's not no excuse, and I know that now. I know that now, and I'm here to take accountability, to ask for everybody's, please, to know I'm sincere, I'm apologising, and please, I'm asking you, please forgive me for what I said. It will never, ever, ever be used again. I'm sorry. I can't take it back. But I'm on here and I'm trying to let people see that I'm sorry.
Well, just on the back of that, guys, it's a public apology because it was on a public platform, but I need everyone to really understand the same way everyone's backing Pearl and stuff. Like I said, everyone deserves support, but I need you not to have the same sort of energy towards Laura. Like, she doesn't have to accept the apology. That's the thing. Yeah. Like, everyone, do you know what I mean? And everyone can have an opinion, that of course, 100%. But same way that, you know, people are saying she shouldn't have to apologise, Pearl shouldn't have to apologise, the same way that Laura doesn't have to.
Because now I know something wrong. Directed.
Yeah, like when it's directed towards her. Like, yeah, no worries. When it's directed towards her, she doesn't have to accept the apology. Like, and this is what I said. The reason certain people are having such an issue with what Pearl said is because when you have grown up in environments like we have, when these situations arise, it's either one of the two. So it's either white privilege playing a part by saying, if you didn't know, that is your privilege. Like, unfortunately for us, your privilege is not having to consider us in that room in that time. Or the other time when these situations normally happen, it's when someone who sort of uses these words on a genuine occasion and on a backhanded occasion, and it's just their real selves coming out. Do you know what I mean? They're the two times these kind of things normally happen. It's when you're angry and you shout something out. So if you're saying the intent, it's not something that you say, or you don't, you know, talk about black people in a derogatory way in your own private public spaces and stuff like that, then it's obviously a white privilege at play. And that's what the issue was, and that was the thing. So if, like, Laura doesn't want to accept the apology, you can't, guys, then go run and call her a bully when it's...
This is what I've said. I've apologised to her. She said she's not going to accept it, and I'm sorry. I'm not apologising no more. I've apologised. I can't force the woman to take the apology. That's it. She's chosen to accept it. I can't do anything about it.
Yeah, so everyone in the comments, you can't call Laura, though, a bully, or you can't call her aggressive for not accepting it. No. Like, people, it's their prerogative completely whether to accept an apology. Like, do you know what I mean? Having the conversation. But what my thing is, yet again, the backlash of these kind of conversations is that now everyone in the comments is going to come for Laura to be like, she's aggressive, she shouldn't accept it. That's what I mean, but that's where it always goes, Pearl. This is why we get, as a community, sometimes so offended, because it's like, we're never allowed to actually just have a moment. Like I said, Angie sat on live screaming about Alex, etc., and really, like, loads of random stuff for weeks on weeks on weeks. And there's been people that have given us sympathy, people that have been, you know, vice versa. And I've not heard one person call you, like, respectfully, I don't want them to, but I've not heard one person call you aggressive. Like, you were shouting and you said, like, you know, obscene words and stuff, and you were saying swear words. I hadn't said one single swear word and I was getting called aggressive, but you didn't. And that's the only thing for me. It's the nature of how people are looking at us too, as both creators, but I'll get called all the negative connotations and then you get the sympathy side from it more. So it's like, oh, bless Pearl, like, do you know what I mean? And stuff like that. But I'm aggressive. But you was both shouting at the same, you and Laura both had a moment where you both lost your shit, do you know what I mean? So if one's aggressive, then you're both aggressive. My issue is there's no negative connotations put towards you, it's more sympathy.
My page, baby, you got to that point because I was all the way through calling her Laura. She called me, she kept calling me love. I said, Laura, please, my name is Pearl, stop calling me love. She constantly kept calling me love and I just, that was it. We were like two... whatever got horns, and we locked horns and that was it.
That's what I mean though, but my thing was, I'm not judging you, Pearl. Like I said, I'm actually known as judging jury. I promise you, I don't care what anyone does in this app. I just like to look on the outside perspective and I like to compare. So my thing is, if you do want to call Laura like aggressive people in the comments, which is your prerogative, like I said, you don't have to like everyone, but I need you to have the same energy for Pearl or EQ when they have a breakdown and start screaming, because it, even in the breakdown and the screaming and the words and the swear words, you guys are still not getting called aggressive. But I'm still getting called aggressive no matter what I do. I could be sat there crying, like begging people to understand my point of view, and I'm still the aggressive one. Do you see my problem? So you're never going to be liked by everyone. You're never going to be hated by everyone, type thing. But at the same time, I just think it's about, you need to make sure, like, if you're holding someone accountable, hold the other person accountable. If you're going to have such negative, like, connotations and, you know, stereotypes and just perceptions of one person, I don't get, if you're not having it for someone else in the same box doing the same thing, the only difference I can see between the two people is race. That's why it's a very techy conversation and it's very touchy.
Yeah, no, like, exactly. Wait, can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Oh, hello. Sorry. I'm boxed out moving for a second. Hi, Pearl. Hi, Jay. Hi, Mike Page.
Hi, Pam.
Yeah, I was just in, I got shared Angie's live and was spammed to come in and was in there and explaining everything. I think what this is, Pearl, and I understand, like, I've followed you for ages and I don't personally believe anyone's born racist and I don't think that you're racist in that sense. But I think sometimes context is what's really, really, really important when, you know, certain phrases are being just thrown out at people. And I think the way that it was said in the heat of the moment, in the mix of an argument and whatnot, it was said to the wrong person at the wrong time at the end of the day. And I think where kind of people were really, really coming at you. And I think, I don't know if you remember, I asked you a question last night. I said, have you said it to somebody that's white or black before? And you said, no, I've only said it to white people. Yeah. And that when that, and that's exactly what it was. It was the fact that you've never actually had the repercussions that you had last night because you hadn't been in that situation before in that context. So really and truly, that was where you kind of should have just stood back a little bit and just said, you know what? Educate me, tell me why I'm wrong. You know, I've never said it to a black person, so I don't know how a black person could be impacted or how a black person might find that offensive. But actually, Laura, the other girls that are in the box, it was myself, Paige, and Torian, tell me why now that's offensive to a black person. And we honestly, I don't know about the other girls, but for myself, I would have happily, instead of attacking you, I would have said, you know what, this is the connotation. That's why it's, you know, offensive. Then I think you would have probably changed your tune a little bit and probably didn't have your back up last night. And I think that's where people are really frustrated at you in that sense, because you got your back up. It wasn't that you weren't understanding.
I was mad.
You were mad, yeah.
And when I get mad.
Yeah, I know. We all do. We lose our shit. That's what it is at the end of the day.
And when I realised what I'd done wrong was when I was waiting to get back in the box. That's when I was I had to sit and look at the comments.
Yeah.
And that's when I realised the wrong that I'd done.
Yeah. No, I'm glad that you realise now. And I think instead of the whole, like, it's all well and good saying, I'm sorry, I've apologised, I'm not going to apologise again. But what's an apology without kind of understanding why you apologise? It really doesn't hold no meaning.
And that's what this is about today. I need to be told what I've done wrong, how I've made people feel. So that's why this live's on for today. And I didn't want people who are my followers and whatever coming in the boxes. I wanted people who don't know me to come in and just say, well, you were wrong, you made me feel like this, you said this and this. So I totally understand now,
understand.
I've said something, so I'm sat here and I will take whatever to say to us.
Do you know what it is as well, like, I agree with Paige, like, I never ever want to see you, like, you're very much, you know, you're an older person to us and we have a level of respect that we need to give to you regardless, and that's just my own principles, but I don't want you to be upset about it or cry and feel like people are attacking you. This shouldn't be an attack. It shouldn't be, oh, we're going to attack her because she said this or she's a racist. We're not going to get anywhere if we constantly just attack you for it. We need to come up and we need to tell you, right, if you're in a certain context where there's black people in the room or black people on the stage, just be mindful of what you say. And if you don't know, please don't be afraid to ask, because no one's going to gun you down for that. Like, do you know what I mean? And that's what I really, really hope the people on TikTok that come in your boxes realize, that attacking you is not going to get us anywhere. You're putting us back 20, you know, 200 years odd into slavery again, where our voices are not heard. We feel much better as a community if we sit there and say, do you know what, Pearl, you said that, but where do we go from here now? How can we educate you? How can we tell you not to say it again? Because you might be in a room with the black person again on stage in a box. That's all that's necessary from these lives. Like, people need to stop with the attacking and name calling and whatnot. Just sit back and be like, do you know what? You said this because of that, and that's why I feel offended by it. Like, this attacking thing it's a joke. Like, why are we going to attack? We're not going to get anywhere by attacking people. Ignorance is still going to be there. Do you know what I mean? So let's not do that. But yeah, that's all I wanted to say. Lots of love, guys. I'm gonna jump down now.
If you need me,
share me the live, yeah?
I know we said obviously we're not gonna hate, but I'm just, these comments, guys, riling me up.
I'm not even paying attention to the comments page.
But do you know what?
Just honestly ignore them.
I don't ignore the comments though, guys, because I'm not sat up here for clout or respectfully, I'm having the conversation with Paddy, you guys. The conversation is so much bigger than us. The comments are so important. If people that study sociology will understand things like that.
Absolutely.
It's about the whole aspect of the whole situation. The comments are so important because this is what's breeding the issue and society of the racism within our society. So everyone sat here saying, leave Pal alone, like, you're bullying Pal. Like, where was you all when I was sat in a box then?
Yeah,
discussing this in Andrew's live or Miss Red's live.
I wanted this live today because I need to know what I done wrong, how I affected people. Because if I don't know what I've done wrong and how I affected the people, how can we move forward?
Exactly. And to be fair, Laura wouldn't even take her apology. Like, she's going to sit there and be like, well, she's just saying it because she's got the backlash and people are coming at her. But if you were to then say, actually, no, Laura, before I apologise to you, this is why I know that, you know, you were offended by it. This is my understanding of it. That means so much more and carries so much more weight than I'm just sorry. Do you get where I'm coming from? It actually resonates with the person and makes them feel, actually, you may not never walk a day in our shoes, but you're one step closer to understanding our struggles and why we find that word offensive. Do you get where I'm coming from? And then the sorry can come afterwards. And I think Laura would be a little bit more receptive to that, I think. And anybody else, I think, can agree to disagree, but that's my opinion. Honestly, Pearl, if you're having lives like this, like, don't feel like we follow each other, you follow Paige, please share it to us. We'll jump on, we'll talk. No scream match, no nothing, yeah?
No, I don't want to.
Right, lots of love, guys. I'm going to drop down. I've got a little one to go feed. All right, bye.
Bye.
Are you okay, Pearl?
Listen, I have to be, because I have to sit and listen what people's got to say to us, so...
Paige, do you think it's reasonable for Pearl to come off now, or?
Yeah, like, honestly, you can do what you want. If you want to take a week off or do whatever, like, no one can tell anyone what to do. The thing is with me, it's just, I need everyone to just really have that same sort of consideration to the people that I've, it's like,
I know everyone's saying that Pearl's like looks tired and it she liked and is, you know what I mean, stressed out, but do you not think like I am, do you not think Laura is?
Yeah,
do you not think every single day of my life I'm opening up messages and getting told to get out of my own country I was born and bred in? Do you not think I'm tired of having people saying I love this conversation? I don't love having to have this conversation, which means that my sons don't get called the N-word when they come home at 11, 10 years old and told they can't play football because they're too black or their hair's too curly or their afro hair or can I touch your hair or they haven't got certain products or black people still within society. All these little things in this aspect, black women are dying at a 4 times higher rate giving birth. So now when I go into the hospital just to have a baby like a normal person, I have to be more scared than a white person. All of these things condone and like sort of make white privilege an issue. And this is what I'm trying to say to you, Pearl. The reason why you have to just sort of hold it and firm it if she don't want to accept your apology, it's not a bitchy thing. It's just so many times people have said apologies to us to do damage control. And then,
listen,
do you know what I'm saying though? And then it carries on and it carries on. So it just gets to a point where it's like we don't want to, I'll have the conversation happily. You know I will, I'll happily have it with you, with anybody else. But I'm just saying you can't expect every black person to continuously have the conversations. Do you know what I mean? And that's what it is. And it's just like the sympathy that everyone's having for Pearl. Like I've sat up and cried all night too. I've got two kids. I've got two small kids. I didn't go to sleep till 6:30 this morning. I'm sitting there replying to DMs, like I'm jumping into other people's lives. I'm making sure I didn't say nothing to offend anyone. And I'm making sure, do you know what I mean? We can have a sort of a peaceful life as possible. I didn't want it to be a slanging match and all this kind of stuff. So there is a big grand scale like of like effect when it comes to racism. Like we can all be affected by it in different ways, but don't sit there and think that, you know, just because Pearl looks sad and stuff and that we're bullying her. Because we could turn around and really say that I feel bullied by a lot of people on TikTok for not being able to stand my ground and, do you know what I mean, speak to Pearl about her apologising or be offended by what she's
just for reference,
like
you're not bullying Pearl. Pearl does not feel bullied at all.
Okay, good, because, yeah, the comments in the live yesterday, I was like, relax, sorry, I'm the opposite.
I'm a million miles away. Sorry, no, I don't. You know I don't, my Pagey. I know I can always speak to you. And I hope you always know you can speak to me.
100%. But yeah. What I just want everyone to know is that just because I can be like, you know what I mean, not I can like sort of tone myself down.
You're
or
just
I don't...
passionate, Paige.
Yeah, but then my other thing is not every black person has to be like this either. Like if someone does come in screaming, same way Ange comes in screaming, same way EQ comes in calling people fat and no one calls them aggressive, that's my problem. So if their prerogative as a black woman is to come in shouting and say, lift up your idiot, do you know what I'm saying? Then you can't call them bullies either, because unless you're calling EQ, unless you're calling Ange, and people still associate and be around them, that's my problem. So it's like a black woman, we have to get told very on a daily basis how we can be, and we're very policed and we're very controlled in real life and especially on social media. So it's like if someone was to come in, guys in the comments, and she's like a bit more aggressive or he's a bit more aggressive, or you think their tone's aggressive but they're passionate and they're upset and they're reliving traumas and they're explaining to Pearl, you need to stop calling them bullies and you need to stop trying to police how black people are. We're not all going to sit here like me and Han. I'm mixed as well, which is why I'm like this. Can I just say, like, I've been to university, I had to school myself on how to talk. I literally had to teach myself on how to talk. I've had less racism than a full black person has, this is my point. And I've had a lot. So you can imagine what it's like for a dark-skinned person in society nowadays. When I've got mixed race privilege, that's my point. So we're not all going to have the same approach, and we shouldn't do, because not every white person has the same approach. So that's just my thing, like, what I want to leave it on is, if someone says something in a different tone or in a different manner or is a bit more hype than the other, or one cries more, no one's more a victim or more aggressive. Like,
there's
every
no
black
victim.
Person has the right to
Can
be them.
Can I just say this, Paige? There's no victims, and that's neither on my part or Laura's part. And why I'm saying that is because I have had a video sent to us where Laura is fist pumping in the air and laughing that she got me to that stage. So there is a video there.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want to say that, so...
I get what you're saying, I get what you're saying. But I feel like more, it's probably like... Yeah. No, I get it. That's what I mean. I'm not here for the personal vendettas between two people and stuff like that. Mine's just more... It's more the effects when you guys bicker on lives and stuff. Yeah. And it's the effects. Like I always say, I'm on the outside. I'm a sociologist. I like to look at the bigger picture. So all the comments and all the people and each of your followers
Sorry,
that
me,
now
me,
think...
I'll get ready to... It, can you see how it's... Zoomed in now, I don't know. Girls, can I chuck you out the boxes for 2 minutes and come straight back?
Yeah,
in
cool.
The live's going to shut down.
Yeah, of course.
There, stay there. Oh, there, come back in. Jane, Torian, request the box again. Sorry. Oh, I don't even know where the comments has gone. I don't know how you put the comments back on. No, just turn that off. I'll have to let... Where's Jay at? Where is Jay at? There she is. Sorry, girls. I don't know what happened to the live there.
That was all right. But yeah, that was just my biggest thing before I come off. So, it's just a bigger implication that you guys have when people are having said arguments, like I said, and then it affects all, like, it's like a literally like a bloody trickle of effect, isn't it? Because now it's gotten to the point where we're all involved, and it's like, I'm not, it's not about being too kind. I just want, I'm not going to approach things with anger, because it's like people, not everyone listens to certain things in, do you know what I mean? Some people, if I can shout at them, they'll hear me straight away. Some people have to really, like, you know, make sure that I'm not gonna be offended, like offensive towards them in any way. And if that's what it takes for me to speak to them in that type of way, for people to actually listen, then I don't really care. I'm not really egotistical. I can drop my pride and stuff. That's not a thing for me. But my biggest thing is it's just the implication, like, of what's been said. And that's what makes me just think, I hope everyone knows that. It's,
I am here taking accountability of what I've said, and now I am well aware of what I said is not in no way, shape or form acceptable. But I also, my page, off that video that was sent, I don't think it's acceptable either for what I've just seen. Do you get where I'm coming from? So...
I hear what you're saying. I completely hear what you're saying. From your perspective, like I said, I'm very devil's advocate, but on the just the grander scheme of, like, racism and stuff like that, do you see when, like, I always say you can be, like, victim or perpetrator, you can't be both. Whereas yesterday, you two could have argued, and if you never had said that at the end, Carl, you and she'd said something mad towards you, you would have been the victim in that situation. Then you could have been like, she shouldn't have said this, blah, blah, blah. Where you've obviously turned around and offended, like, a mass community now, that's where it's like... I get what you're saying, and it's and that's what I mean. I get that you're sorry, but it's more of the fact it's like, now you have to just let people be angry, and people are going to say things, do you know what I mean, in retaliation. You can't rush people's healing journey when it comes to, like, accepting apologies and stuff like that. And even down to the comments now, they're like, move on, move on. Like, if I, as a black person, for instance, didn't want to move on, then I shouldn't have to. Same way Headband sat on her life for 2.5 weeks talking about one specific person. Marlon, and that's really, not even a math thing.
I'm not even talking. Paige is talking. What are you talking about?
Hey, did someone tell you to stop?
Yeah, like, what the fuck?
Oh, Marlon, I'm jarring. I'm sure, Marlon, that's fine. That's absolutely fine. I'm sure your mum would love me. Let's go for afternoon tea one day. But anyway, my point is, like, it's just, yeah, I feel like let's just stop trying to police how black people, like, are offended and the aggression on it. Do you know what I mean? Like, if someone comes up and says SYM, then let them, because EQ comes up and calls people fat and she still gets the respect and decency to sit in the boxes with big creators and stuff like that. So that's just my big thing. I love a bit of afternoon tea shows. So I'm gonna jump down now. Hi, baby. Yeah, we're gonna shove our face full of a takeaway because I'm starving. I'm absolutely in pain. My back's burning. I'm tired. But yeah, I just big love to everyone. I love everyone. I want everyone to love each other and equality forever. Thank you. Bye.
We love you, Paige.
Bye.
Oh, she's making me want a takeaway now. Fuck's sake.
Sorry. That's it. I'm just saying. I just don't know.
You okay?
What else to do? So
why don't you get yourself a drink? Make a cuppa.
I'm going to come off, and it's 4:20 because I'm at work tomorrow. So, but listen, I just needed to come on and know. Again, I've learnt my lesson. I'm apologising. I'm truly, truly sorry, whoever I've offended. But I don't know what else to say. So, but listen, thank you, everybody. Whoever I've offended, like I say, I can only apologise, learn from my mistakes, what come out of my mouth, and that's it. No to the comments. I won't be coming off the app. I won't be going anywhere because...
Because you're not.
Because, yeah.
Because you don't want to.
So, I'm sorry who's ever upset that I'm not coming off the app. You'll have to deal with it. I'm here. I'm not going anywhere. I've owned me shit. It's cockapoo. Where's cockapoo? I've owned me shit. I've learned from the things that come out my mouth sometimes is not good. Well, they're really bad. So, I've learned from it.
Right, cockapoo.
Yeah, I was just going to say, Pearl, I mean, I'm not quite sure when your live started. I didn't get the share, but from my perspective, you've sat, you've listened, you've tried to understand, you have, you know, given what I think is a heartfelt apology. You know, let anybody who has never, ever made this sort of mistake ever, and I don't just mean, you know, calling somebody a name that can be considered racist. Let anybody who has made this sort of mistake, you know, let them come up and explain why they're perfect. And, you know, because that, nobody is, and we all make mistakes. And I just want to say that I can see that you understand now the impact of this, and I can see you're going to go away and you're going to really hear what people have said today.
Not only that, she's not just had it on the app, Cockapoo, let's be fair. We've given it to her off the app. And Pearl, I didn't want to upset you, so please. I'm sorry.
Say what you want to say.
I never wanted to.
Morning, and don't think that I haven't took it from left, right, and centre. Listen, I know I've done wrong. Now I know I've done wrong, right? And that's what this live was for today, because I don't just want my friends pulling us up on what I've done wrong. I want everybody to come and tell us what I've done wrong. So,
what I want to say is that from the people that came up in the boxes that I heard, massive respect, because they could have used it, as Paigey said, they could have used it, and rightly so, as an opportunity, you know, to scream and shout and tell you about yourself. But what they did is they came up, they explained how they felt, they told you why they thought maybe in that circumstance it was wrong, mm-hmm. and maybe to also consider other things that you hadn't quite considered. I thought Janelle, you know, sort of explained some stuff, and Misfits, I think her name was, explained some stuff, the people I heard. And I want to say, it's not, you think you can do this, you think you can get up in a box and you think you can say things, but actually it's hard, and people don't want to talk about this, even if they are black people, people of colour, you know, whomever, they don't want to get up in boxes and talk about it, because they don't want to become a target for the people that absolutely reject the point of view. Yeah. So big up to everyone who did that.
Yeah. But Pearl... Oh, cooking out. I think I've upset my fucking a lot of my friends this week, giving them a bit of honesty. I think I need to stop.
On a daily basis, Jay, so at some point you piss me off, I'm not going to lie.
Oh, that's sad. Crock of shit.
Stop sending me them videos.
Crock of shit, mate. That's what I'm calling you from now on. Pearl, are you okay?
I'm good. I'm going to come off for a little bit, but please, listen, anybody... I know I've disappointed lots and lots of people, but now I know how that word come across, and I'm going to try my best never to use it ever in that situation. Now I am aware of it, but I am going to do my utmost best to stop using that word, full stop. And it's going to take time, because it's something I've said all my life. It's going to take time, because I don't want to be shown my grandchildren that it's okay to say that word when I know now it's not. So I've got things to work on myself. And you know, it's right what they say, you're always learning. And I'm just one of them, I'm going to have to be learning more than most, because people say she plays on this and she plays on that. Listen, it's not nice to come out and tell people that you're not a full shilling, right? And I'm not. I don't understand a lot of things, but I definitely did not understand it, the impact at what I said to a certain person was going to have on this, on here today, so... I'm just sorry, and I apologise to everybody who it affected. I can't say no more.
Listen, unless we get a cross out and hammer your hands to the cross, I don't think there's much more you can do today, love.
Not today.
But listen, thank you very, very much, everybody, for coming on. And like I say, them who's disappointed in us, you'll have to unfollow us and whatever. I'm sorry, like, move on, because I'm always going to be me, and I'm going to fuck up, I think, lots of times, because I don't know. Listen, I don't do it anything intentionally. It's not nice being in this predicament, and it's my own fault that I'm in this predicament. But now I've learned from my mistakes. Yes, unfollow. Anybody who wants to unfollow, feel free. I can't force anybody to follow me. If you do, you like me for me and you understand me. And if you don't, I can't make anybody follow you. And I can't do no more but apologize. So listen, it's down to you. There's no hard feelings. You'll never, even if you unfollow you, you'll never be stopped from coming in my room. As simple as that. So honestly, never ever feel bad about that, because if I didn't like somebody, I'd unfollow them. But what I'm trying to say is, if you unfollow us, you'll not be stopped from coming in my room. Yes. And it's as simple as that.
Listen, everyone's got their own pace. Everyone gets there at different points, and some people don't get there, and that's their choice as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, we're done.
Everybody, listen, have a lovely day, and the one last time, I am sorry, truly, truly sorry.
What time are the cocktails?
You know, I'm at work tomorrow.
Okay.
But I will, if you want, I'm not bothered. Come on and have a couple of games and have a chat and whatever. It's up to you, but...
Do you know what, Pearl? I just think that you need... some complete downtime. I think
I've come on here and then, oh, she's not coming on tonight. Listen, but I'd prefer tonight, because not to come on here, if you know what I mean. I just, you know, when you want to get your head around what has actually happened,
yeah,
what I've actually said and what I've actually done to people.
Yeah, that's what
I want to get my head around.
Oh, Arthur, no one's laughing. Piss off. Honestly, it's people like you that just cause a massive uproar when everybody's had a lovely conversation. It's been decent. Pearl has been educated. We've told her that she's been an absolute Kent. So that's that.
Right, everybody. So thank you, everybody, for just having your opinions, listening. And like I say, sorry. So all yous have a lovely afternoon. I keep thinking it's Sunday, it's because I'm at work tomorrow. I have a lovely afternoon, and maybe tomorrow night when I'm finished work, and I'll come on and have an hour for whoever wants to watch. But listen, big love to yous, and
I'll speak to one of you. Okay,
thank you.
Bye. Thank you, everybody. Big love. Thank you. Love.